Hello everyone, today we have something new from the wiring loom. In the last video I converted my imaginary vehicle from AC to DC power. And now it's about time to add a few small electrical accessories. That's why I went shopping at Zip Scooterscope and bought a few things. We have a Zip speedometer, an LED indicator with matching relays, a USB socket, an extension for measuring the exhaust gases of the speedometer, an LED headlight and an LED module for the rear light. We'll start with the Zip speedometer because it's the easiest and the most important thing we're going to install today. And the most important cable in this whole circuit is the free blue cable, which was intended for the preparation of the indicator relay. Here we see the blue and the white cable running up to the turn signal switch. At the moment, however, we are only interested in the blue cable and the mesh, which we simply get from the screw connection from the controller. We will now start with the black box. The connection of the black box is relatively simple. We have to connect the power carrying red cable to the blue one. We connect the black cable, which is the ground, to the ground point. And where you connect the brown cable for the speed pickup, I'll explain in a moment. Before I firmly connect the black and red cables to the vehicle, I first check how many connections I need on the systems. Before that, I connect the USB socket and the USB cable to the connector, which is included. Thus, it also gets power from the black box and you could, for example, charge your cell phone with it or something else. I do the same with the converter box from the exhaust gas temperature tool. Here, the same cable is supplied. The two-pole cable is connected to the temperature connector of the speedometer. And this long cable that comes with the speedometer connects the black box with the Zip speedometer. And now, let's assemble the whole thing directly. Here I have installed the two black boxes from the speedometer and the EGT sensor with the USB connection on the left cheek. The voltage supply cable and the temperature cable from the speedometer are simply routed through the tunnel to the top of the speedometer and connected to it. I bought an additional signal converter, because it is a little bit difficult to make the speed pick up on the DC board. Installing the converter is relatively simple. The tab with the screw is simply clamped onto the ignition cable. The red cable is the power supply, the black is the ground, and the white cable is connected to the brown from the black box. It displays the RPM signal into our speedometer via the black box. The speedometer is then set to 1 for the speed signals. We now have the red and black wires from the black box free, as well as the red and black wires from the converter. We also have our input cable from the turn signal relay, and they all need to get power from here. I will now show you the easiest way to make a power distributor without having to connect it with the snap lock connectors. This way you can easily detach it again and it looks clean. I have a couple of female and male flat connectors here, eyelets, our cable connectors and a few cables. I know that I need 3 connections for plus and 3 for minus. So I first cut myself 3 cables of the same length. I take a connector, I cut one cable a little shorter. At the non-isolated part of the cable, we attach a male flat connector. Before you clamp the flat connector, you have to pull the heat shrink tubing over it, otherwise you can't pull it over from the thick side. And on each of these 3 cable ends we make a female flat connector on it. That will be our power distributor. I have already prepared the same for the ground cable. This time not with a cable lug, but with a ring cable, so you can put that on the ground point. Now I crimped the counterparts to the cables from the black box and the signal converter to be able to connect it then. Now, before we connect our two distributors to the vehicle, we need to disconnect the negative terminal from the battery. You should always do this when you rebuild something in an electrical system, then nothing can happen. First, the plus distributor, then the black box, and the signal converter. This wire is for our indicator relay, and this one is for our ground connection. All of this is then screwed onto the ground point here. Now we are missing our indicator relay, which we plug into the third branch of the power distributor. Red is the input of the indicator relay and black is the output which runs into the supply line of the switch. What we haven't done yet is to connect the signal from the converter to the black box. I've prepared that here. We'll plug this together now and thus we would have all the cables connected. We have attached a cable lug to the signal cable from the converter and the counterpart to the input of the speed signal from the black box. Now we can put them together. With that we now have everything connected down and before we reconnect the battery, we check again to make sure we did everything correctly. We started with the speedometer and wired the black box. Plus via the distributor to the fused plus from the ignition lock. We have the same plus the signal converter. We have also fused the positive line at the indicator relay. The ground wire from the converter and the black box is connected to the ground connector of the frame. On the vehicle, of course, you should lay this neatly with cable tiles so that you don't lose track of it. Now you can reconnect the battery and the whole system works. Of course, this vehicle also gets LED indicators, which I want to show you briefly. They are very simple. Here is a rubber for clamping and here is a screw. And the screw is turned until the rubber goes tightly into the steering tube. Then you can turn the turn signal itself another quarter turn until it is tight. The connection is also very simple, black cable to ground. For example, we can take this ground point at the top of the handlebar from the wiring harness. And the red cable we connect with the L-marked turn signal switch on the right side with the rest of the cables. With this, the indicators are connected and they get the power below through the blinker relay. Next comes the LED headlight, which now has three connections because it doesn't have a parking light. Very classic black mess. The brown cable is for the low beam, the purple colored one for the high beam, which you can plug and play to our harness, the lux fit. Same as the LED board for the rear light. We have a black cable, a yellow cable for parking light and license plate light, and a blue one for brake light. This is simply pushed onto the cables. If there is no cable lug, you can use the accessories from the kit and thus you have everything connected. From my side, that is it for now. Everything is connected. The advantages of DC are that you can connect many devices, as you see. I have only connected a few. The SIP speedometer has many great features. Through the LED headlight you can see more and through the optimized rear light you will be seen better. The LED turn signal just looks cool. An EGT sensor or even a lambda probe will help you tune the engine and protect you from any damage. Plus, it's really fun once you get into it. If you liked the video, ring the bell and leave a like. Leave a comment what you want to see next. I'll see you next time.